Hey guys, in this video I will show you how to set up and install code block in Windows operating system. So before starting this video, subscribe my channel and press on bell icon for further notifications. So let's start. So open Google Chrome and type code blocks, and you see here the first option www.codeblocks.org. So click on this option. So use see here home, features, downloads. So click on downloads. So you see here the downloads, the binary release, download the source code and retrieve source code from SVN. So click on the download the binary release. So click on the download the binary release. So you see, come down and you have to find, hey, there is almost 10 to 12 files of code block to set up in your desktop. So here the first option is code block 20.03 setup.exe. so we have to find, so here the option number fourth, you see code blocks 20.03 min gw setup.exe. so min gw is the compiler of C and C++, so you have to download this and click on source4g.net. click on it. So the downloading will start shortly. Here I have already downloaded, I don't need to download, so I cancel. You have to download it. I cancel it. I show you where it is downloaded. So here the downloads, you see the code blocks here 20.03 in setup. So open it, and I have already installed and set up, so you don't have to install. After installing, you at the desktop icon is create. So open it, here the options code block. Code block, the open source load platform IDE is opening 20.03 version. It can be updated 2 months or 2 months. So here the code blocks is open. So here how to create the projects. So here the, you know, file, how to select files, open to save recent files, you know it, and how to edit, paste new file. So how, if you want to make a C or C++ project, so I tell you how to create a file to write a code of C and C++ language. So click on here the option create a new project, click on it, and you see the pop-up window is open. So here the so many projects of C and C++ is open. You want to graphical user interface or something else you want to, or maybe you want to Java applications or C hash things like, and if you want, so in this we have go for C and C++. So choose here the option console application, click on it and click on go. So here the option, two options giving, C and C++. So choose your language to you want to code. So I choose C and click on next and project file title. So I type help, no, hello, only hello. If you are working in Turbo C++, you have to write .c, or if you working in C++, then you have to type .cpp. So there is no need of this, but you only name the project title and click on next. Then there is no need to change this, just click on finish. So here you have the file, and click on file here and open new and click on empty file, click no. So here I show you one project, small hint to give its future. So for the C, hash include studio.h and hash include conio.h. It is the header files of C language, and the main function is run, and I code only just for the hint how it run and how to save and it run. So I type printf, type hello world, and one more thing, printf channel. Okay, then I have missed one thing, semicolon. So, and save this file. You can also use a shortcut Control Shift and S. So I save this file, save file as, and click on main and save. Yes, do you want to replace it? Yes, click on yes, and you see the color has changed. That means you have or written in C language. If there is error, run this project, click on build and build and run. If you want to shortcut key, so click on function and F9. So I run it. So you see here the hello world, subscribe my channel. So I click here one thing, backslash n, and once more I run it. I click this wrong, so it look good. Everything is mixed. Then hello world, mix, subscribe my channel. So run one more time, build and run. So you see here the hello world, then line change, subscribe my channel. So how we can, so in this video you show, I show how to install or set up code block. So thanks for watching this video and subscribe my channel and press on bell icon for further notifications.